Okay, I'm ready to glue up my door now. Put this panel together. I'm going to dry fit this as close as I can. And then I'm going to coat all my joints, my mortise and tenons with epoxy. The other nice thing about this is it's so thick that when it squeezes out in almost, it doesn't run like regular glue does. So what you do is you just don't mess with it. You just let it squeeze out and it'll form these curly-Q structures, and you wait and you'll just be able to peel it off without any mess or having to chisel it or anything like that. And none of it's down in the wood grain that you have to sand. But if you start smearing it, that makes a mess. So you just let it ooze out, and there's unless you smear it into the wood, it'll just break off or just peel off. You know,
this is a great all-weather glue to use in exterior applications. It will not shrink or deform, or it's completely impervious to water. I mean, you can actually mix it together and it will set in salt water. So I like to just usually mix it on a piece of plywood. So I think this is a good amount to start with. Oh, that may even be too much. I'm going to take a little bit away. And I try not to mix my spatulas. And I just think I could use just a touch more. And I think that's pretty close to being an equal amount. That's a good place to start right there. This putty knife is too flexible to mix this stuff, because you can see it is thick. It doesn't drip or anything, and when it's mixed together, it's still that consistency. So I use this thicker putty knife, and so this is also really nice because you can really thoroughly mix it together, because you're not having to worry about racing. Okay, so that's good enough right there. That's well mixed together. And I generally start inside my mortises. And I am a firm believer in 100% coating. I don't, this stuff is so thick, you cannot expect the pressure to move it around where you want it. So I want to make sure that I have coated every spot with the adhesive. And it just doesn't take that long to do it right. Oh, you don't have to worry about getting it other places, because this part has not been sanded. And since this part's been finished, if it squeezes out onto that, it won't adhere to it. Let me get a little stick to get back up in. Really make sure I got that end grain good. Yeah, that's the ticket right there. And that smears it along the bottom too then. Okay, so I'm more than happy with that. I'll do my tenon now. Yeah, I didn't mix up enough, I can already tell. But that's good, because I'm not going to be wasteful. I'll just mix up more as I need it. Okay, so something like that. So I got it. Complete coverage.
I'm ready to start assembling my door now, but since I'm standing this up on its edge, the last thing that I want this to happen is for this to fall over and make a huge mess and to damage my panel and my door. So here's a little trick that I've used for years, just to hold stuff. Standard hand screw, and then a clamp on the hand screw to your work table. C-clamp or whatever you've got, and now that just can't go anywhere. And it's really easy to move if you need to move it. But this is just a really quick and dirty way that I hold stuff all the time, whether I'm hand planing it, routing it, whatever. Chopping mortises so the piece doesn't flip over on you. Okay, so let's slip this guy in here. So I've got these marked. So this is number four, that's number four. Go ahead and try to get a pre-squeeze on this. get it kind of lined up the way it's supposed to be, the way I dry fit it. And remember, I don't want to smear this. See, I'm so glad I'm not racing with tight bond right now. I got all the time in the world to get this the way I like it. You know, if I had to take this out 5 times, I'd still have time to do it. There's my final one right there. Okay, slip it in. If you could only take one glue, if you got one choice of glue to take to the desert island, that's the glue you would take, PC7. The only thing it won't work on is it won't work on plastic. And it doesn't shrink away, so you know it's gonna fill up this joint. Any little spaces inside are now gonna be filled up with this. If I can get this done, a glob of this stuff in my hair, that'll be a first. One of the reasons I like to be so careful and get every little spot, even though this end grain doesn't really have a real grabbing effect, this forms a moisture barrier, water barrier especially on exterior doors, to keep moisture from getting in and damaging the joint. So when you squeeze it together and all that stuff squeezes out, there's just really nowhere for water to get in, or very little. And then especially once it's sealed over with finish. See how nice this just one hand screw and another clamp, so you've got this really quick and dirty way. You're not having to balance this thing. It's just a real simple way to hold your workpiece up. Yeah, it's going. See, this stuff is so thick, it's hard to pound this to position. It's very, very tough to do it. There it goes. You don't want to smear this, you just want to leave it like that. And you'll see that you can just take it off in one big gooey thing all at once.